The juxtaglomerular apparatus contains chemoreceptors and baroreceptors in the wall of the afferent arteriole. The chemoreceptors detect oxygen levels. When the blood oxygen levels decline, the hormone erythropoietin is released. Erythropoietin targets the bone marrow, stimulating them to increase red blood cell production, increasing the delivery capacity of oxygen in the blood. The baroreceptors detect pressure of the blood going to the glomerulus. If the pressure is too low, renin is released. Renin ultimately increases pressure to maintain adequate filtration. The macula densa are chemoreceptors that monitor solute concentration in the distal convoluted tubule and the afferent arteriole. This double check of the outgoing solute concentration in the distal convoluted tubule filtrate to the incoming blood solute level allows for fine tuning of the amount of a particular solute that should be retained or released. The renin-angiotensin system is triggered by low pressure in the afferent arteriole. Low pressure in the afferent arteriole can compromise the ability of nephrons to filter the blood. Therefore, the renin-angiotensin system is a very effective mechanism to increase blood pressure, not only in the kidney, but throughout the body as well. When the baroreceptors in the juxtaglomerular apparatus detect low pressure, renin is released into the blood. Renin then combines with angiotensinogen that is always circulating in the blood. This combination creates angiotensin or angiotensin 1. Angiotensin 1 is then converted to angiotensin 2 by angiotensin-converting enzyme, which is found in the endothelium or tunica intima, mostly in the lungs. The blood pressure drugs called ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers, ARBs, target this mechanism to reduce blood pressure in hypertensive patients. Angiotensin 2 increases blood pressure in two ways. It does so by targeting the tunica media of arterioles to cause constriction and stimulate the release of aldosterone from the adrenal gland. So angiotensin 2 directly increases pressure by vasoconstriction and indirectly by the actions of aldosterone increasing blood volume. There are a few hormones that have direct effects on either blood pressure or blood volume. Antidiuretic hormone comes from a posterior pituitary gland targeting the kidney, increasing the permeability of the distal convoluted tubule to water, increasing blood volume. Angiotensin II increases blood pressure by vasoconstriction of arterioles and increased cardiac contraction. Angiotensin II also stimulates thirst, thereby increasing blood volume. In addition to the direct effects of angiotensin II on blood pressure and volume, it also stimulates the release of aldosterone from the adrenal cortex. Aldosterone increases blood volume by increasing the retention of sodium in the distal convoluted tubule, which results in less water being lost in the urine and more retained in the blood. Atrial natriuretic hormone, also known as atrial natriuretic peptide, comes from the right atrium and is one of the only hormones that will decrease blood pressure. It is released when the right atrium is stretched out due to too much blood volume. Atrial natriuretic peptide causes vasodilation to lower pressure and targets the kidney to release more water, which decreases blood volume or diuresis.